Biomass is unique among renewable energy sources because it's so versatile in both sources and availability. It can therefore serve many markets. After coal, oil, and natural gas, biomass is the most important primary energy source. It provides approximately 10% of primary energy supply, mostly in heat generation. Specifically, it provides heating of buildings and heating for cooking purposes, mostly in developing countries. Power supply based on biomass is more limited. Regarding power supply, there are more alternative energy sources than biomass. However, high-temperature industrial heating and heavy transportation market sectors will need a transition from fossil to renewable, and it's in these sectors that biomass will probably play a key role. The largest market is the heat supply market. Consider both heating of buildings and cooking applications, which now use gas, electricity, or wood. Then, of course, the power market can be served. Nowadays, electricity from coal or nuclear power plants form the basis of this market. In this market, the combustion of biomass or biomass gasification are used. As biomass is a carbon source, it can produce carbon-based fuels for transportation. Technologies for fossil fuel-based products can be adapted to produce and use biomass fuels as a replacement for diesel, petrol, or kerosene. Next, biomass can also form the basis of green chemical industry, producing either bulk or commodity chemicals or specialty chemicals. Finally, the materials market, such as the timber industries and the pulp and paper business, is served by biomass. Of course, combinations of markets can also be served. This forms the basis of flexible biorefineries that are able to process different feedstock and deliver a range of products. Let's now look at the biomass market from a global perspective and look at the availability prospects and demand forecastings. One of the ways Earth stores solar energy is by growth of biomass. To be able to forecast the availability of biomass, many constraints have to be considered. Here we can see some predictions for the availability of biomass energy. Each bar represents a different forecast study. For the shorter term, that is until 2030, studies show that less than 100 exajoules can be supplied by biomass, whereas current primary energy use for the world is approximately 550 exajoules. This represents less than a fifth of what's required. However, research into future timeframes show that biomass could, in principle, provide well above 100 exajoules. Currently, biomass cannot fulfill a bigger role in primary energy requirements because we dedicate little or no land to energy crops. This happens because it competes with food and feed production necessary for our human and animal protein-rich diets. In addition, we use only a fraction of the agricultural residues as biomass. For biomass to play a bigger role in sustainable energy, we need improvements in agricultural practices, the use of marginal lands for energy crops, and the use of algae as biomass. The lower end of potential is up to 100 exajoules and assumes there is little or no land dedicated to energy crops. It also assumes that the world population's diet keeps containing a lot of meat, since meat consumption requires a lot of land use. To increase global biomass potential, an effective use of the agricultural residues, like the stems or leaves of, for example, grain and maize crops, is assumed. Scenarios where the biomass potential is higher, above 400 exajoules, pose requirements on the expansion of agricultural land area at the expense of forest. This, together with an intensification of agricultural practices, global population growth constraints, and dietary constraints, increases the global potential of biomass resources. These aspects need to be critically looked into concerning their feasibility. In general, you can say that biomass supply is still larger than today's practice. Biomass can take a substantial share in renewable energy supply of the order of a few tens of percentages and should thus not be neglected. Let's look at the current energy supply in the world. Fossil sources still form the majority of the primary energy supply. Renewables form about 19% of the world primary energy supply. Biomass takes quite a share of approximately 13% in the total primary energy supply. But this is mainly traditional use of biomass. 9% of current energy use is supplied by burning biomass in cooking stoves in developing countries, for example. This is not the most efficient and particularly not the most healthy and environmentally friendly way of biomass use for energy supply. The rest of the biomass for energy supply is more modern and is growing in percentage. Thus, currently biomass is one of the most significant renewable energy sources. Regarding power production from biomass, the following slide shows its share among other sources when considering installed capacities. On a global scale, a reasonable share of approximately 100 gigawatt installed is indicated. The picture also shows a differentiation among different geographic regions. In some of them, solar PV and biomass are of the same order of capacity installed. For transportation fuels, biomass can ensure production as its availability is relatively abundant, and conversion technology known for the fossil industry can, in an adapted form, be utilized. Biomass processing can generate drop-in fuels in existing infrastructure. So, in conclusion, biomass now provides more than a tenth of energy supply, but mainly in traditional forms. There is potential for a bigger and more efficient biomass share for power generation and transportation fuels.